Welcome to our innovation sprint.
Our particular project is how can we potentially remove dry salt cake waste from the Hanford waste tanks in Washington State, take the emerging robotic technology and use them in these tanks to remove that waste. So the goal is design and build a robot dog capable of digging a hole. You'll have 1 week.
When we first heard what the challenge actually was, my initial inclination was, oh boy.
We're taking apart robots and putting together new robots. How can we get something similar to an animal and actually have a good dig?
There's a significant time crunch on us to solve this problem within 5 days.
The fence is a secondary challenge. None of us have ever worked with this before. I'm really excited to see what everybody's come up with in a week.
We've spent most of our time working on our digging motions and a little bit of time working on the feet.
We were able to get something knocked out. It's not pretty, but it let us test.
Bend this and run it again. Bend it, run it again.
Yeah. I'm feeling pretty confident that we'll at least be able to dig a hole. Not so sure if we'll be able to get under the fence. We'll have to see what happens.
I refer to us as robot surgeons because we've had two robots that have died. So we've completely changed directions and are now building a new robot. The main focus of the design is trying to get the best paw to move out the most amount of dirt as possible. What have I learned so far? Perseverance.
Our design philosophy was not getting too fancy. Using the tools that were given to us by the manufacturers of the dog, working with the tools that we had instead of trying to work on the tools that we had.
Is that better or worse?
We're fortunate enough to not have a lot of mechanical failures. Who do I think is going to win? Us.
What we're trying for is having basically snowshoes. The potting soil is very loose. The robot will sink immediately, like very deeply into the potting soil without some sort of flotation. We've iterated a few times on the shovel blade design, but basically got the backhoe excavator type attachment. I'll be very curious to see which approach pans out, but we've got some ringers on our team, so.
The thing that you are able to adjust on this dog are really the feet. Right now we have a claw design. It kind of looks like a hawk. When it moves forward to dig, it's got like this back ridge that will move the dirt away on the next pass. I would like to win, but you know, the best part of the innovation sprint so far is that there's this like spirit of teamwork going on. I do think we have run into every issue first, so I'm gonna say, we're going to win.
All right, you're gonna have 5 minutes to dig as deep a hole as you can.
Squirming!
Say 6 inches past the fence. All right, tell us when you're ready.
One minute. Seconds.
3 inches past the end of the fence.
Yeah,
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, very good.
Thank you, everyone, for participating.
The way we chose was how much material was extracted, how far the robot made it up to the fence, adding features that were above and beyond, and the presentations.
We have 2 awards, starting with 2nd place.
It was all a very, very close race, but somebody's got to be first.
We are.